Hello, chess aficionados. I bring to you this interesting game between Nakamura and Cheparinov. So maybe we can say Naka versus Chepa. Anyway, so it started easy enough. Naka is white and Cheparinov is black. So they're even, Steven. This is a Russian game. For most of it, as you can see, black is trying to really rush out there. Look how fast he is. White castles, black castles. Maneuvering, take, take. Okay, move that bishop away. As you can see, it's still pretty even, Steven. So it was a very balanced game. Okay, so it looks like white is starting to force more moves. See, he's attacking, so the queen has to move. For the most part, I saw Hikaru Nakamura making more forcing moves like this. See, he has to move back. And now he has to take. Okay, so they are minimizing, getting rid of their pieces. Okay, now we're going into the end game. So we have knights and rooks. Let's see how many pawns we got. 1, 2, 3, 4 for black. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for white. But still, it's a little bit slight advantage for black. I mean, for white, excuse me. Okay, another check. They only did one blunder each. But the black's blunder seems to be much more significant. And it came on move 54. So we're still a far away. They're just jumping around, repositioning at this point. And the blunder for black is coming. Don't you hate it when it's just one move and it's a game over? That's how chess is, especially at these higher levels. Okay, with these knights, those are tricky. Knights in the end game, especially, you got to know how to move those knights. And look what's happening here. This is the huge blunder for black. Yes, it is. Knight to e1 was best, and it's all over for black. So I suggest put this particular piece on the board and finish it off. Practice your endgames. Thanks for watching. Au revoir.